Welcome back to Turning Hard Times into Good Times. I'm your host, Jay Taylor, and I'm really, really glad to have with me my business partner, Chen Lin. He's with us to update us on a couple of his favorite biotech stocks. Thanks for joining me again, Chen.
Thank you, Jay. I appreciate the opportunity.
Always good to have you with me. And let's start out with Sarepta Therapeutics. You know, that's a stock that's traded as high as almost $42 over the last 52 weeks. And it's currently down around the 12, I guess 12 and a half or so. I didn't check it today, 12 and a half or so. The company has a drug that has shown great promise for curing a form of muscular dystrophy that kills young boys, takes their lives at early ages, and keeps them in wheelchairs for most of their lives. A very sad story, but a very promising drug that Sarepta has. Talk to us a little bit about where that drug stands right now and what might be a driver. I mean, you seem to like the stock in spite of the fact that it's gotten whacked really hard over the last few weeks. So why do you still like this, and what's the story with Sarepta?
Yeah, the story, I mean, I've been with the stock for quite a few years, 3-4 years. I mean, when it was in single digits, I discovered that. I've been writing this. Actually, I probably made them more correct call on this stock than every Wall Street analyst. I mean, we talk about that like just a few weeks ago. I mean, mm-hmm. I was telling people to sell when they hit 40, right?
Yes.
40. And even, you know, the hedge fund who've been there for so many years, they didn't sell, and then they came back to me and said, "Wow, Chen, I wish I listened to your, you know, advice."
Uh-huh.
So now at this price, market is pricing complete failure. Okay, but actually the story doesn't end there, right? So there is the line, you know, in the past many years, follow this so many years, the line always been, that division of the FDA, so basically the central neurons division, that division has been extremely conservative. They wish just to use the old way. You do phase 1, 2, 3 and then give me results, and then they don't like Sarepta, gave them phase 1, 2 and ask for accelerated approval. That's the bottom line. They don't like it. They haven't liked it a little bit and never changed. They've been like that for how many years, right? So that's why it makes Sarepta, you see the stock so volatile. You know, when we first invested, it was single digit, and then when the data was good, went to 50, right? 40, 50. Then FDA said, "I don't like the data." Right? It went down to $10.
And well, Chen, Chen, I know that the criticism is that the number of participants in the trials have not been very large, and I suppose that's a valid criticism, but why do you think can you speculate as to why the FDA doesn't like Sarepta's drug?
So it's not like or dislike. Okay, FDA does not want to change their way doing business.
I see.
It's not the FDA top level. Top level, they're required by the Congress to, there's a new law passed for fiduciary, they have to do it. It's in the lower level. It's in division level. They hate it. That has been all along. You see the stock 50, 10, 40, 10, 40. I mean, now 10 again. Right. So I was able to just ride that back and down, up and down for so many times. Because I know every time you go stock, people get excited, then FDA came out with something like this. Always. So now we are crunch time. We're going to have the advisory committee. It was delayed from last month. I heard latest will be this month, late this month. So we should have the final say from the committee. And the street has viewed this will be complete failure because previously there's another candidate, biomarine candidate was shut down by FDA. People, you know, investors always think, oh, this happened first time, the second time will be a repeat, but it's not exactly a repeat. They're very different. Things,
yes.
Right? Biomarine is very poison, you know, very, you know, there's a lot of side effects. Even at AdCon, people say they can kill someone, right? So Sarepta is very safe. There's absolutely no side effect. And then they don't, biomarine doesn't create dystrophin. In Sarepta, it does create dystrophin. The argument actually was, they create about 3 times as normal dystrophin at DMD, and then FDA, from their briefing document, that division don't think that's sufficient, but it's higher than normal, and then appear those patients are doing better. So does it have an effect or not? Is efficacy established efficacy or not? The answer, I believe, will be yes.
Right. So the advisory committee, Chen, the advisory committee is an independent committee that provides advice to the FDA. Is that right? And then the FDA can do what it wants with that advisory committee's recommendation?
They can, in theory, they don't have to follow, but they always, almost always follow that. Partially also because this is public pressure is so high. You know, FDA director themselves will be, you know, Janet Woodcock will be on the AdCom. So they will sit down, sit through that. So if the advisory committee approved, recommend to approve it, I believe FDA has to follow that.
Yeah. If they don't, I would think they'd open themselves up to some lawsuits possibly.
Not necessarily. There will be congressional hearings.
Yeah.
There will be a lot of them. You know, FDA is a political animal, right? A lot of it's a government agency, political animal. They want their job, bottom line, right?
Well, Chen,
Yeah,
go ahead. Go ahead.
If they don't, if there's overwhelming evidence and then as to approve it and AdCom recommend to approve it, I don't think they dare to challenge that.
What's the upside for this stock? Let's say that the advisory committee comes out with a strong advice to move forward on it. What do you think can happen to the stock?
Well, before this bad news came, it was $40, and the people were talking at that time. People were talking about approval could go to 100. Well, with all these correction these days, maybe lower than that. You know, you're looking 60, 80. I mean, still right now it's $10, $12.
Yeah, it's huge.
So that's what I'm looking forward to.
All right. Well, of course, this is a reason you need to subscribe to Chen's letter to keep up to date. We talk to Chen only occasionally here on this show, and I comment briefly from time to time a week or so later in my own newsletter about what Chen's saying about some of his favorite picks. But if you want to really take advantage of the hard work that Chen does, the due diligence that he does trading his own account, you need to be a subscriber, and that's, again, go to miningstocks.com for that. Well, Chen, let me ask you, Sorrento is your other favorite biotech stock, and it's also one that I've added to my newsletter as well. I like this one a lot, but tell our listeners, why do you like it?
Oh, because it's under the radar. Most of the people don't know that, Wall Street doesn't know that, and has some incredible technology that can actually lead to cure of cancer. It's not an understatement, and I'm not just joking. They have truly first-class technology that can actually, for mankind, once for all, cure cancer. But, of course, it's in the biotech, you never know until it's being approved. So it's a possibility, okay? But the key was nobody put that into any consideration. The stock is barely trading at above their cash and short-term investment, and then they have another $600 million sales milestone. That's $1.2 billion milestone coming, and the market cap of this is like $200-something million. So with over $100 million cash.
And
so
the $600 million is coming from what? Chen, the $600 million is coming from what?
For another thing they sold to Patrick Soon-Shiong. It's another candidate for Civilac. You can check it. It was sold last year. So it's a $90 million down payment and then $1.2 billion milestone. And, you know, for Patrick Soon-Shiong, that's the richest doctor on earth, he doesn't write a check, $90 million for nothing. Right?
Yeah.
You know that. So it's in the pipeline, but people just forgot about that. Investors tend to be very short-sighted. They just look, all the biotech are down, so I try to better sell. I better, you know, run for the cover.
Yeah, one thing I understand that people aren't paying any attention to, but what could be absolutely revolutionary is a technology that they are working together with City of Hope on, and that has to do with cell penetration, where they could deliver the drug inside the cell. And nobody else has been able to do that so far, right?
Right. Nobody was able to do it effectively as they are doing, and then they can deliver the antibody inside the cell to kill cancer, to go to the root of the cancer. Plus, not just cancer, also many other diseases, but this one can be a holy grail. But it's a very early stage, okay? Even before the animal, I think it's an animal model right now, so they will take a few years to develop. But of course, investor has no patience on those. But however, they do have four phase three drug candidates, right? They have also many other phase one, phase two. So in terms of pipeline, this company is amazing. You know, they have cash. They have over $100 million cash. That should cover them for the foreseeable future. cash and short-term investment. I'm talking mm-hmm. together, okay? And then they also have all the phase one, phase two, phase three, all the pipelines. And they also have investment in all the different Patrick Soon's company, portfolio company, and they also have the technology. So they seem to have everything. In biotech, you know, whatever investor want, they have. And they have everything. But just market was very bad. And, you know, it's right now it's $5. It's back to where I bought it 2 years ago.
Yeah, it's around $5 now today. I think it was 10 just a couple of weeks ago.
Right. Fortunately, I sold some when it was 20-something in the summer. But, you know, it's just amazing round trip. And it's just the people's biotech is very hard to trade per se, okay, because there are so many machines programmed, they trade it, they just use different algorithm. They can drive the stock up and then drive stock down.
Well, and you look for opportunities because you're
one. Yeah.
Yeah, you're focused on the fundamentals, Chen, and you look for opportunities. We're just out of time, but I wanted maybe 30 seconds comment on Pan Orient Energy. They just, I guess, just announced they're going to come out with a dividend of 40 cents on a stock that's trading at around $1.20 Canadian, 40 cents Canadian, $1.22 earlier today, Canada. What it seems as though the market must be thinking this stock is going out of business, this company's going out of business, as it's down even a little bit today, or it was earlier today after this announcement.
Yeah, Oil was down. That's why stock was down a little bit. But you know, stocks, the company's still trading at below cash, and then they have a history of paying dividend. They paid last time, they paid 75 cents. This time, 40 cents. They are selling their project one by one. So I expect more dividend coming, and it's trading below cash. You know, how bad can it be?
And so within the next 30 days or so, people should have a nice check or a nice piece of change in their account, I suppose, if they own this stock now.
Yeah, the shareholders. Yes.
All right. Thank you, Chen, for being with us. We'll have you back again, of course, sometime very soon.
Thank you, Dave. Appreciate it.